right, so I have to say that Pastor ID, as we fondly call him, mm-hmm. and Pastor Shiju Ileomade were my pastors. So first thing I must say is that in terms of their personality and character, it would be remiss of me to not say that.
Hello everybody, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. I greet you in the name of our Lord Jesus. How are you doing? God bless you. Welcome to End Time Truth Television. 3 months ago we brought you the story of Pastor ID and his wife. You know, the celebration of the 60th birthday of the wife, Pastor Shiju Ileomade. Now, you know, some of us brought the story and we condemned it in every way possible, that was being, you know, heartless and mindless and not being emotional at all, even though the people who are close to them, you know, have said that they are not like that, but it was a very costly mistake. That is for those who tend to admit the fact that such thing happened. Then eventually stories started emerging that the man, the pastor and his wife, the two pastors, have been suspended, but that the pastor, you know, refused to yield to the directives of him handing over the church to the pastor that was supposed to take over from him. And in fact, that was a story that I also saw that was carried. I also reported it anyway, even though somebody called me to tell me that that was not true. And so because I wanted to be on a safer side, I have seen this story, you know, on the newsprint media, but I waited until I will be able to find out something that is concrete. So I will show you the video where an insider of the church, who is also a national television, confirmed the fact that the man had been suspended. Now, as I was saying, it was even said that even the former vice president of the country was in support of Pastor Ileomade against the authority of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, because it was rumored that the former vice president was not happy with the general overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God over the role he played in not giving him full support during the APC presidential primaries. That was what was, you know, put out there. But we know that the advent of social media means that somebody can even be you and is telling lies on you, you know, on the social media. You are there and you wouldn't even know that that is what is happening. Now, I will show you the video of the news reported and the affirmation of the lady who said that the couple, the pastor and his wife, happened to be her own pastor. And, you know, because a few days after that, I also saw some reports on the social media debunking it, saying that the man was not suspended. So you see, that is the darkness that we have around us. People will just be lying with their teeth. But now that it is on the national news media, I will show you this. And then at the end of this, there is also another video of a particular pastor of the Redeemed Christian Church of God who had similar issues with the church and the way he handled his own. We're going to look at these two. Please stay, don't go away. God bless you. I'll be coming back with the full story of the second pastor.
You are welcome to the End Time Truth Television, the channel for the lovers of truth, for the truth of the end time. So if you are a lover of truth, give us a subscription and God bless you. Shalom.
aid of labor. We'll take another story. The Redeemed Christian Church of God over the weekend suspended Pastor Idowu Iluyomade, who is the pastor of the City of David Parish and the head of the Apapa family of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. The pastor was reportedly suspended for 3 months by the governing council of the church in response to the public outcry against the extravagant 60th birthday party of his wife, CG Iluyomade, shortly after the death of the late Group CEO of Access Bank, Herbert Wigwe. Many believe that the birthday, which was celebrated just about a week after Wigwe's death, was in bad taste. Herbert Wigwe had been of immense blessing to the church before his transition, and so the party suggested the church had no emotional attachment to him. All right, we always talk about optics. I mean, this was bound to happen. I mean, it would have been a shame if this suspension didn't come. Aya, you know I'm coming to you because you are our pastor in the house. I believe that he's been replaced by Charles Bande at
yes,
this
pastor
point.
Charles Bande.
I mean, this conversation, I'm sure a lot of Nigerians have been talking about it. Yeah. I mean, how does it look at this moment with the church?
All right, so I have to say that Pastor ID, as we fondly call him, mm-hmm. and Pastor Shidri Iluyomade, were my pastors. So first thing I must say is that in terms of their personality and character, it would be remiss of me to not say that these are people who have really contributed in terms of their community, society, and have been and are upstanding citizens. And unfortunately, this might have been an error of judgment, which caused a lot of outcry when this happened. And I know that there were plans for the church to wade in and come in, and that's the bigger church now because of the structure of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. What has happened here is a suspension, and it's said to have happened following internal processes involving the governing council of the church. Now, you cannot legislate how an entity decides to, handle a matter. And for a number of people, it seemed like, oh, yes. But I believe that it's beyond just, you know, what's happened with them having the party. That's Pastor Shiju's 60th birthday. People know how to want to celebrate life, love life. But there was also the challenge of perhaps the wrong timing and the call by a number of people. He's not been taken out permanently. It's a suspension.
It's a suspension.
And Pastor Pande, interestingly, was his church that the service of songs, the Lagos edition of the Wigwe's services were held. So he's now gone to City of David. So we'll see how this works, just the early stages. But at the end of the day, what I'll just say is that when it comes to the internal workings of an organization, they have a process of handling matters that are contentious, and the Redeemed Christian Church of God has done just that.
As regards Pastor Iluyomade, yes, I get the fact that, yeah, there are a lot of things. In fact, I remember the Arise Project by Pastor Siju and all the other great work they have done. But let me tell you something. It has to be said, some error of judgment can be very costly. The Bible says, when people are mourning, you mourn with them.
Yeah.
And the optics look particularly bad.
Absolutely.
And like we argued on this table, celebrations could have been suspended.
Yes.
So whatever Redeemed Church is going to do as regards this, the suspension is also to investigate.
Yes.
So an investigation is on. We leave it to the discretion of the Redeemed Church and all
right.
of that. But we also should set some terms clear. Nobody's bigger than the church institution, because we've heard a lot of yiggity biggity in the back. All right? And with or without anybody, any religious institution will move. The house of Christ is marching on.
Yes, well, I would like to align myself with a comment that was made when this story came up. The question was, if it was the pastor's wife's son that died, would she go ahead to celebrate her birthday?
Good question.
That's the question. Well, let's take our final.
Now, this will take me to the second video that I have on this matter. You know, because that last time it was rumored that the loans that Pastor ID got for the City of David, that it was not done in the name of the church. But there is a video I will show you. There are two things in the video. Now, the man in the video, the former pastor, who was also a senior pastor in the Redeemed Christian Church, but was based in the U.S. Now, said that there was a time they were called, they were asked to a kind of come together and have a single headquarters where everything would be under the same head, you know, from that headquarters overseas. And he explained the reason why the thing did not work. Now, people were saying that it is possible, quite possible, that Pastor ID would just, you know, rebel against the authority of the church and would change the signpost of the church and put another name there. And I've heard Pastor Adeboye saying things like that, that the only thing he would want is that whoever that wants to rebel against the authority of the church should just remove the signboard of the church and put whatever name he wants. So people were a kind of saying that Pastor Idiomade may go that way, but now that it has been confirmed that another pastor has taken over from him, that route has not been taken and that route has not been chosen, which is actually a credit to the man himself. Now, but something like that happened in the US, and the reason why the man in the video I want to show you took the step and decided on what to do, Pastor Tola Odutola, now explained vividly why he took the step he took. Now, apparently, seems to be that there is a difference between the running of the church here in Nigeria, the running of the Redeemed Christian Church of God here in Nigeria, and how it is done overseas. Now, you won't understand this. There is another video I will, you know, upload that tells you how, you know, the thing is run overseas. And to even think that the pastor in this video referred to this church as an organization, somebody may find it difficult to understand why I'm trying to sound the way I'm sounding. But relating the church as an organization sounds more like a business enterprise. And actually, when you hear what you know was said in this video is not recent. Some of you may have seen it. Some of us, I'm seeing it for the first time. So it might be the first time for, you know, some of us. Now, why I'm bringing this video is that there is another story that is developing, which I just saw today, but I'm going to wait, sure that it is true, from the camp of Pastor Idowu Iduyomade. I'm not going to divulge anything because I don't want to sound false. I don't want to give false narrative. But until that comes to fruition, it might not make sense for me to divulge it. But before then, or till then, let us hear and listen to Pastor Tola.
It's good to see you again. Tola. Thank you, guys.
And the proposal was to merge all the churches in North America together, for them to drop their tax-exempt numbers and we come under one tax identity. Many of us rejected the idea. And one of the reasons for the rejection of the idea is that if any church in Idaho or any part of America does something wrong and they want to sue them, they will sue everybody together. One of the other things that we said was that if you want to get a loan to do a building or anything, it has to be central, which means everything that we used to enjoy as an entity, we have to go to the central before it can be approved. Either we want to apply for immigration, you know, for any of the pastors or mentalists or people that work. It's impossible. You have to. Now, 2 or 3 years ago, there was a proposal. The issue was brought up again. They laid it to rest then, and we thought it was over. Then this common purpose agreement, 38-page agreement on the same issue. And part of the things that was written on it was all the churches, we should hand over the buildings and all the assets, but not the liabilities. And we said, who does that? You know, why would I hand over $10 million of assets and $4 million liability will not belong to me? Is it my father's business? You know? And they said, people said no. Later on, they came up with a 3-page agreement to sign. We showed this agreement to our lawyers. And one of the things the lawyer said is that slavery ended a long time ago. Because some of the things that were there, it's unbelievable that it's a Christian that drew up this. So when I saw the 3-page letter or agreement, I said to myself, how did 38 pages become 3 pages? So what happened to the rest of the 35 pages? At that time, trust had been lost. I went to God in prayer, and for me, it was a no-go. I cannot sign the document and lose my soul, because I felt if I sign that thing, it is out of conscience, and I can't. So I refused to sign. Then a year ago, they wrote us a letter saying, if you don't sign, you are no longer part of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. I said, that's okay. And they said, we'll give you 1 year. We spoke back and forth, but nothing happened. So I knew that they were eventually sending us away as a church. So in February this year, they wrote another letter saying, now that you have not signed for 1 year, you are no longer part of our CCG. So in April this year, I resigned, and just as Baltimore resigned from the organization RCCG North America and RCCG all over the world. So from today, this in fact is our first Sunday as an independent church, not under
Woo! Organization. Yeah. Slavery is over. Are you kidding?
I want you to know that this was not a decision that I take lightly.
Mm-hmm.
I have served in this church for 30 years.
Mm-hmm.
30 years that cannot be taken back.
Mm.
Because if you add 30 years to my age,
oh my God,
I'll be 91.
Mm.
I served for 30 years with nothing from any organization to say you have done well.
Oh my God.
But I know that God is a rewarder.
He's a rewarder.
We are
for
God
you.
Is a rewarder.
Pastor. Hey, we came from Rema to Global, so I understand. Woo!
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Let's be seated. I know there will be many people out there who probably you are disappointed by my decision.
I'm not.
I apologize, but we are not going back.
Mm-mm.
Amen.
Never going back.
I know after this decision, it's not likely that I will be demonized on social media. It's okay. The only thing I ask of you, don't bring those reports to me. Because I want to focus on the job that God has given me. You want to fight it on your own, it's okay.
Mm-hmm.
As a good child, when somebody abuses your father, it's okay for
it's
you
okay
to
fight. It's okay for you to fight, yes.
But I just don't want to be distracted. And I want you also to know one thing. I have made up my mind, I will not throw stones. Because I helped build that church for 30 years. I will not trust you. This is the last time I'm going to talk about this. We are going to move on with life. Is anybody hearing me?
Mm-hmm.
And I want you to know that my destiny, your destiny, is not in anybody's hands.
Amen.
It's in the hand of God.
Hallelujah. Woo! Well said.
It's in the hand of God. It's in the hand of God.
Well said.
Yeah.
Now, the only thing I will say here is that, unfortunately, this is the narratives that make people, you know, these are the things that make people look at the church as a business enterprise. Now, because it's like everybody is interested in what is happening. Now, listen, the man said he queried if that was his business, but you know, somebody may be looking at him to criticize him for saying that. But how do you actually want to inherit, you know, assets? And then if there was a loan that was acquired by same ministry, maybe in the name of the man, or he used his residential documents to acquire those things, that loan, you don't want to inherit it. Now it goes down to for us to begin to question the rationale behind certain things that people are doing today. You know, there was a video I brought you the other time where barrister Femi Falana, SAN, now you know, likened the Redeemed Christian Church of God as business center.
Fella sang about religion, and this is very important, because I was just reading Pastor Adeboye, who has just said that he wants to establish more church so that everybody can have a church within a walking distance. Now, Fella sang about religion and the danger of religiosity as opposed to spirituality. Now, Okoye Akadina Okoye has just given a beautiful reply this morning, that what Adebayo is talking about are business centers, not religious institutions.
All right. Now, and when you look at the whole problem and what you saw in this video, you will find out that everything boils down on money. I begin to ask myself, how is it that we're not actually contented? How is it that, you know, people are amassing wealth, and they are never satisfied? See, I was discussing with a pastor, runs a very small church, and he told me the things that they have done, and he himself was asking question that if they, on their small scale, you know, strength, could take care of the persons and the people they have taken care of, and they have been able to do a lot, Why is it impossible that these mega churches, you know, don't, it is almost impossible to, it is looking like an impossibility for them to genuinely and truthfully help people, for them to genuinely and truthfully affect the community where they are in. And that comes down to the point where and the how is it that everybody, you know, whether they are called or not, wants to venture into ministry, because some persons will sit back and will calculate 1,000 naira times 1,000 people every Sunday. That gives you 1 million naira. So they go into ministry with the intention of making gain. Now, so somehow, if we look at the times the man used, it was like he served man for 30 years. Some of us may fault him by asking, so was it man you were, you know, working for? Or has anybody actually given those who have served in this, all these ministries, the reason to think that, yeah, well, you are not serving man, you're serving God, but also that same God you are serving has the intention, good intentions for you? I even would have asked, if a man goes into full-time ministry and have served for 30 years, is there anything like the program of retirement for the man, for the pastor? Are there plans in place for them? I don't know, but I'm just asking. Because I understand that in the civil workforce, for instance, in Nigeria, you are either retired at the age of 65, or if you have put in 35 years of active service in government. Now, but I don't understand, I don't know if there are plans for the pastors who have served for many years. You know, if that man 6 years ago had served for 30 years, if you take 30 years away from my age, you know, that time, I won't tell you how old I was then, but definitely probably was still learning how to be boy, right? That was then. Don't try to guess my age. I'm a very old man, you know, ancient, white hair on my head. So you don't know how old I am. All right. Well, let me know what you think about it. What I'm trying to say is that so many people are going into ministry. Please, I'm not talking to Pastor Tola now. I'm talking to us. So many of us are going into ministry for the very wrong reason. And when we get into ministry for the very wrong reasons, if those reasons are not met, some of us become very dangerous. Some of us give up on the way. And at the end of the day, this thing will in return give the church a bad name. Now, I want to commend again the Redeemed Christian Church of God for taking the action they have taken against Pastor Idowu Iluyomade, because if they didn't do that, it would have sent a very bad signal to the public, and it would have meant actually that the man was bigger than the ministry. And again, I commend him and his wife that they have complied, and you know, pending on when he would be released, then it might be true, or if it surfaced before that time, what I am hearing, you know, about him recently that has happened. But I want to also, you know, ask leaders, the papas, the general overseers, that question I asked, you have an answer to it. Are there plans for pastors who have put in long active years of service? If that man was saying, as at that time, that if you add 30 years to his age, he would have been 91. That means that he was 61 when he was giving that talk. And then he started as a pastor with the Redeemed Christian Church of God at the age of 31 or something. And so he has given in all of his youthful life to the service of the Lord in the church. And according to him, if you could read from what he was saying, all the services he was not appreciated. And there are some persons who are taking advantage of the fruition of their services, and they have been sidelined, and even up to the point where they want to be cajoled into surrendering and submitting what they had labored over the years to build. And that resulted into the action that he took. Now, before I forget, surprisingly, the members in that church applauded him. Now, that is why, you know, as a pastor anywhere, don't allow people to push you to hell. I do not think that if Pastor Adeboye was in that church and said something, the same people who were calling him Daddy G.O., who would always refer to him as Daddy. Now, a person under the same Daddy G.O. was announcing to them that they have removed the signposts. They have changed the name of the church, and it is no longer under the government or the governing authority of the Redeemed Christian Church of God of Daddy G.O. And all of them applauded and clapped. So you can understand, human being, that is human being for you. There is nobody that you can trust with your life. Don't defend anybody with your life. And don't be so careless and be carried away. That's why Jesus said, that the Bible said that Jesus didn't commit himself to man because he knew man. He needed nobody to tell him about him. Now, that same people. And somehow, I believe that he must have discussed this with, not, may not be with the general public, but maybe with some of the leaders in the church, what was happening, the decision he wanted to take, and all that. Then he went ahead to encourage them to, if they want to fight for him, that they could. I also think that even though we desire it, you know, that when somebody is fighting you, when somebody is trying to intimidate you, you wish you could have somebody that could fight back on your behalf. Yeah, it is, we generally like it, but somehow, sometimes looks like something that I don't think is necessary because it sends some kind of wrong signal even out there to the public there, because there are some persons that when they come to defend, when they come, they will really fight. They will fight with vulgar languages and they will get threats and what have you. And at the end of the day, looks like we are raising which that's in it. Well, anyway, I leave you here. I want you to tell me what you think about this development in the Redeemed Christian Church of God. Bear in mind, I'm going to bring you a video where a pastor, so to speak, you know, was seen on video talking to a group of pastors of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, giving them something that looked like, sounded like, you know, rebellion against the authority. But until you listen to him, you may not understand why such was happening. At the end of the day, money should not be the inspiration behind somebody saying that he has answered the call of God. God is calling you. God will sustain. Thank you so much. God bless you. See you in the next video. See you then.